When I joined railway, that time the outsourcing was only in the civil engineering sector. Now there is a, you cannot mention that which sector the privatization have not crept in. In electrical engineering, in mechanical maintenance, even in operations in some of the areas, in offices, even in accounts and ministerial work, almost 58% work of the our reservation have gone to the in the private hands, maybe through IRCTC or some other agents. So it is not visible practically, but privatization have crept in a very we will say in a large manner in the Indian Railways. Yes, of course, the government, this government or that government, I will not say that India government in the past, in its first instance, they formed a Rakesh Mohan committee, and that Rakesh Mohan committee has given their report that almost all the activities in the name of core or non-core should be divided, and all non-core activities, they have said, should be given to the private parties. When I put a question before the board that what is core and what is non-core, so they have no answer. Practically they have no answer. But as a trade union, as a general secretary of the All India Railway Federation, we analyzed that whatsoever little activities we are running in the profit are the non-core. Because nobody will come to enter any corporate or anything, nobody will come that they should take all the unprofitable services of the Indian Railways, which are too many. Well, we are, if we are today in the government sector, we are only because of the freight, not because of the passenger fare. That is the main problem. But that time Rakesh Mohan has suggested in the name of core and non-core. Now again, this government came, they brought another guy named Niti Aayog member now, who is Dr. Vivek Debray. He has given a report. And in that report, he has said that there should be structural changes in the railway, and those structural changes directly leads towards the privatization, wholesale privatization of the Indian Railways. Fortunately, they could not do so, because up till now, I can't say how long it will prevail. Up till now, the federation has been able to resist the such type of able designs of the reports which have been given to the government. But the government, as their policy, they are trying their level best that they must move on the path of the privatization. We have tried our level best. There had been change of guard on railway because of some accidents. And the new minister is very energetic, and he is putting all his energy that how quick there can be the privatization or corporatization. And therefore it has become very essential, and we are also on the war path, that we have to be collectively, we have to be united, we have to see that there should not be that much privatization. And we, as much as possible, we should be able to safeguard the interest of the user of this country, because almost 8.6 billion people we used to carry in a year on our trains. It is more than the population of whole world, more than 1 billion. the entire population of Australia, you can say the New Zealand, we carry on our trains every day. But Montel Singh Ahluwalia has also mentioned the same things. He wrote to the board that in all the whole world, the railways have been privatized. So what is wrong if Indian Railway cannot be privatized? So that time also we told him that you don't know the country, you don't know demography of the country, you have become the vice chairman of the planning commission. But I very lightly raised a question before him in the Vigyan Bhavan where he was in some seminar. That if you are talking like this, then you must see that who are travelling on our trains. Today also I was in a seminar, somebody was telling that the air tickets are 2000 rupees, you are increasing your dynamic fare and all that. So who will travel on your trains? I said that there is no dearth of the people, those who are only depending on the Indian Railways. You are everybody, every policy of the Indian Railways, which is in the media, which is in the talks, that is for only 5% people, those who can afford to travel in the by air, who can afford to travel by the first AC to AC. Nobody is making any policy. They will talk of the pizza, they will talk of the e-catering, they will talk of the some services which are needed only for the 5%, less than 5% people, those who travel on the railway. But 95% people, they are the poor people, common people, and for them, if people think that these should be privatized, or they should be given to the operation, should be given to some private parties, I think the country cannot afford that. And they are, as the All India Railway Federation, which is an organization led by Jayaprakash Ji, B.V. Giri, and veteran socialists earlier. So we are also of the view that we have to not only consolidate the strength of our working people or our employees only, we have to organize and we have to capitalize the strength of our users also. Because if something will happen to this Indian Railway, then definitely there will be a great loss to our consumers, our users. So looking this problem, I hope that up till now we had succeeded, that there had not been wholesale privatization of Indian Railways. But it is a fact that there had been much privatization of Indian Railways, which is unvisible, number one. Number two, there is large number of efforts. Government policy is that the Indian Railway should be privatized as wholesale. There, up till now, we had been able to put a stumbling block on that. We had been able to resist. I believe that the countrymen, all the trade unions, they will be able to nurture the efforts from all the corners of this country, and we will get the support from the values also to save the railway. And that's why we have given a slogan that we have to save railway because we want to save the country. Thank you very much.